Hi everyone, welcome to our webinar, The Secrets of Real Estate Buying in Florida. Here we will cover the myths, facts, and secrets of the Florida market, as well as how to earn on real estate in 2018. So just a little bit about our company. We are USA Market Group. We've been real estate investors since 2006. We have professional real estate agents on our team since 2005, and we also have representatives both in the US and Canada. We have clients that range from North and South America to Europe, and we're building relations with international investors in China, etc., since Florida is becoming a more interesting topic. People who are new here, we do this webinar on a regular basis, covering different topics each time. So at the end of the webinar, we'll let you know our next schedule. So this is today's agenda. We'll go over these main topics, from why to invest in Florida to the myths and mistakes before you purchasing, taxes, financing, the types of investment properties, demography, and of course short-term rentals. So why to invest in Florida? Let me just explain some important points. So number one, it's a favorite place for tourists from all over the world. So 66 million tourists visited Orlando alone in 2016. And to give some perspective, the total population of the entire state of Florida is 20 million. So that's quite a difference. Number two, the cities here take first place in terms of the air quality, water, and cleanliness of streets. It's very clean here. There is no state income tax for personal income in Florida. The amount of baby boomers increase every year by 10 million, and this is an additional source for investors. And of course, Florida is always an attractive place for baby boomers, because it's the perfect place for retirement. Number five, 1,000 people move to permanent residence here every single day. Number six, the expansion of the Panama Canal. They actually enlarged it by 3 times last year, and that equals for more traffic for the ports in Florida. Number seven, around 70% of all real estate transactions here actually occur by cash. And this makes the market more stable because there's less mortgages and less people borrowing money from banks. The headquarters of most major world banks and corporations are in Florida. And number nine, finally, the average price of a house in Florida is about $217,000, that's from 2017. And there was a stable increase by about 7% from 2016. Next, we'll move on to the demography of foreign buyers in the USA. So this just shows how many foreign investors invest into USA as a whole. And Florida is one of the top 5 states, as you can see. China takes the lead with $31.7 billion. On to the next slide, we see here exactly the Florida statistics for international investors. So as you can see, China is not on the list because this actually shows residential transactions, and China mostly purchases commercial land. But this will dramatically change in the next couple of years because, as you may have heard, one of China's top investment locations, which is Canada, they introduced some new rules and restrictions regarding foreign investors last year. So now those investors are looking for other investment outlets.
So the top 6 myths. So myth number one, the Florida real estate market is unstable. That's simply not true because, as I said before, the market went up by 7% in the last year. And as you saw from the graphs or the information from before, it's one of the top 5 states for investment. Myth number two, I cannot buy a house or get a mortgage in America as a foreigner. This is as well not true. There are a bunch of mortgage and bank programs for international clients. It doesn't matter what country you're from, we have a wide selection of how to buy using your personal name, corporation, etc. The bottom line is there's no limits for international investors. Myth number three, When buying, selling your home, you need to pay a large tax. So when you buy, your closing cost is about 2 to 3%. And when you're selling, you have great options such as an investor. So thanks to the IRC Section 1031, you can reinvest your profit into a new property, defer all capital gains. Or you can apply for an exemption from withholding certificate by providing the supporting documents. We have accountants on our team, so if you have any specific questions regarding that, you can contact us. Myth number three, when buying, selling, oh, sorry, is this myth number four? Right. I need to travel constantly to the US for my property management. So that's also a myth. Because that's one of the biggest things that actually stops people from purchasing in the US. They think that they have to constantly travel to manage the property. In fact, in Florida, there are a lot of professional property management companies who take care of all the important duties such as cleaning, dealing with tenants, marketing, etc. And we ourselves also provide property management services for our clients in South Florida. Myth number five. This is everyone's favorite. In Florida, it's risky to buy a property because of hurricanes and floods. Well, everyone knows Florida has the hurricane season from September to October, and there's just a few things you have to look for before purchasing a property to make sure that you know that never really causes a problem for you. So you don't buy properties in high flood zones. You can check that information online. You don't buy properties built with old materials like the roof, the wall, etc. And just a fact, from Hurricane Irma last September, the only real damage done to property was in Key West because the houses there are around 80 years old. So again, that's using the old material and that's why they were damaged. For example, right now we live on the front line here in Fort Lauderdale, and the only damage we had was a few broken palm trees. And myth number six, when owning a house or apartment, I have to pay a lot of insurance. So when we help someone purchase a property, we always make our own due diligence, which includes finding out the history of, oh, sorry. Moving on to the next point. Regular home insurance can be no more than $100 per month, and it's also optional if you don't have a mortgage. So the main mistakes before purchasing. Some people, when they, advise with someone who's representing themselves as an agent, they don't know for sure if they're an agent, just take the person's word for it. So you can actually check this information online by going to myfloridalicense.com. And here you can enter the person's first and last name. And find out if their license is active or if it's revoked or suspended. And stuff like that. It's very important to check. This is one of the most, basic things. Number two, selecting an area to buy in. So obviously we all know what we don't want is a more crime area, and what would be more profitable and safe is less crime area. And you can check this on a site called Trulia.com on this link, and it just shows you the different crime zones and how much crimes occur in certain areas. Number three, checking the owner and previous purchases. So this is important because you don't want to have yourself purchasing a home and then later when you already own it, finding out that you have some liens or restrictions on the title, which prevent you from either renting it out or selling it to someone else or anything like that. Number four, the cost of transaction closing, the closing fee. So you check this on facc.firstam.com. So this just basically covers your closing costs. You can choose the county where you're buying the property, your city as well. It basically gives you an overview of how much as the buyer or as the seller you would be paying for the closing costs. Yeah, this is just a continuation. So it's showing here for this property, which was 300,000, buyers paying around 2,100, or sorry, 4,300 actually. You go, all right, moving on. Yeah. So when you buy a resale condo, especially on the first line, this condo could be sometimes as old as 30 to 40 years old. And if the property management didn't maintain the property very well, it can require a bunch of money to repair. So this is also called a special assessment, which can tremendously increase your expense. So try to do your due diligence before buying. Make sure you don't have that, extra charge. You should ask for the resale certificate to avoid this problem. The most important here is to check for any code violation to make sure that you don't have any unexpected charges in the future, which can be very expensive. So, as an example, we have here this photo. It's very popular in Florida. People like to convert their garage into a third or fourth bedroom. And obviously, you would need to get a permit of that. And if the seller didn't get the permit and you buy the property from him, and later it's discovered that you don't have that permit, so it's a very high charge from the municipality, which is can be up to like 50,000. So it's always good to check for any permits that they have. So financing in Florida, here's just some basic information. Down payments usually 35 to 40% for foreign investors. We have actually licensed mortgage brokers and representatives on our team, so you can get. We don't pre-approve you ourselves, but you can get pre-approved before you have any agreement of purchase, and it's very good to estimate for your budget. Taxes and expenses. So over here, the HOA, that is the maintenance here in Florida. So that's mostly for condos and gated communities, stuff like that. Property tax is usually from 1.75 to 2.25 of assessed value. Your home insurance, as I said before, it's usually 100, can be up to $300 a month. Closing fee for purchase from 1 to 3%. You can check that on the site we listed before. And then utilities are over here for condos and houses. So Florida is actually one of the seven states in America without a personal income tax. And you could see here, just as an example, is we are originally from Ontario. So in Florida, the tax bracket is 10 to 39.6%, and Ontario, it's a bit higher, you see here, 26.6 to 46.16%. And now we are going to have Serge present our types of investment properties. I'll hand this over to Serge.
Hi, so we continue types of investment properties. Actually, there are a bunch of them in Florida. If you compare, for example, with Canada, because a lot of our attendees today from Ontario, it's much more Florida can offer. So some of them, it's long-term rental. This is by default, this is regular rental that mostly all of the investors use. Short-term rental, this is not everybody use. We are going to talk about it a little bit more. Vacational property, buy and hold. So actually, it's very similar what a lot of investors did up to today in Toronto. So they buy property, they hold it, assuming they're going to increase in cost. In Florida, it's similar strategy. The only thing people buy usually, since they cannot live there, for vacational purpose. So it means they using 2, 3, 6 months. After that, they just stay. And in a couple of years, in 10 years, especially if they don't have mortgage, they just sell it. It's the easiest strategy, actually. You don't need to do anything. Project development and construction, again, it's in Toronto now, even if the prices go much, not much, but let's say 20-30% down, let's say to build the house, GTA, you need at least 1 million, because good land cost up to 1 million, plus you need, actually more than 1 million, plus you need some construction cost, at least 500. In Florida, Great Miami area, or east part near the Mexico, Mexican Gulf, you need 30-50,000 just to buy land, and additional 200,000 to build the house. This is separate project what we're doing. I'm not going to talk a lot about it today, but people who interested, because I already like every week I have 1-2 calls, people who particularly interested in build something, either to resell or for themselves. So we also have very good opportunity. So if somebody will be interested, you can contact us later by email, by phone. A repair for quick resale, fix and flip. This business, it's not so good, of course, like let's say 10 years ago, because not a lot of property on auction for good price. But if you like this type of business, especially it's good for people who was involved in home improvements or like handyman back home, there are always properties 150, 200, 250,000 that require 10, 20, 30,000 repairs, and you can make easily 10-15%. Zoning conversion is it's a little bit not like complicated, but require maybe more money. It's more interesting for people who like big development. For example, you buy a piece of land, you convert it from agriculture to single family zone, or you buy motel with hotel zoning, you convert, you apply to the city, you convert it for condominium, you can sell it by units. This type of investment and strategy also very good. Who is interested, we have some interested project for those. Okay, how many sales last year? Alexei, not understand exactly what you mean. How many sales you mean in Florida itself? Guys, you know, can you make me a favor? Can you just please write all the question somewhere, and at the end we are going to answer it.
I see. Alexei also asked the average price. So last year, as I said, it was 217,000. 17. That was the average sale of real estate here, and that was up by 7% from 2016.
Yeah, especially from the last year, price in certain area increased tremendously. Like more and more people understand that if you compare with any other places with this type of climate, either it will be not, you can, for example, you cannot compare Dominican Republic or Panama with USA, or in other words, if you go Aruba, let's say, price will be 2-3 times more. So this is actually what type of investment. Now we are going to talk a little bit more for some of them. Okay. First of all, main difference between short term rental and long term rental. Like everybody know what is long term. First difference, purchase of furniture. So it's actually very simple. If you rent long term, you don't need buy furniture. Usually tenants bring it themselves. For short term, since it's your business, people can come again depending on your strategy, on your goals. Sometimes you put minimum 2 days, sometimes 1 month, sometimes 1 week, but either way, it has to be furnished. This is like you will be your expenses, but at the same time, it's investment in your business or give you much leverage. Next one, advertisement. If for long term, you need to advertise one time per rental period, for example, one time per year, you found tenants, you can sleep quiet for the next year. In case of shorter rental, because it's continued business, you need to continue your marketing and advertisement. But on the other hand, your rewards will be bigger. Utilities. Long term, tenants have to pay utilities, everybody knows. Short term, landlord or your like business owner responsible for paying. Income from rent. On the average base, short term, if you set up it the right way, give you at least two and a half, three times. Three times is actually absolutely normal if you do right steps, starting from location, marketing, three times more than regular rental long term. Personal use, especially it's important for vacation rental. If you, let's say you have nice apartment or single house in Florida, and you cannot live here whole year, but you don't mind to spend 1 month, 2 months, like two times per year. If you use it for long-term rental, forget about it. So you cannot do anything. You need to wait when rental finish, you come. In case of short-term, you're completely flexible. If you use online booking, I show you later, like for example, Airbnb, you can block certain periods of time, days, months, weeks, and for yourself. And going there is afraid that it will be booked or occupied by somebody. So it's actually give full personal use anytime. Guarantee of payment of rent. Everybody knows long term, usually people pay you checks, sometimes post-dated checks, sometimes every month, but every time you deposit the check, you have, there are no money there. Or people, you need chasing tenants to take this check, or a lot of stuff. People here who is an experienced landlord, they know what I'm talking about. In case of short-term rental, much easier. If you use online booking system, all the booking pay in advance, 100%. It means when people actually check in, move into the property, they already pay in advance. And it doesn't matter either they book yesterday, months ago, or 6 months ago. It means if you don't put limit, people book 9 months in advance. It's a lot of times possible, especially here. It means they pay already 9 months in advance this month. Possibility to check the property. Again, it's continue for the personal use. It give you very good control. And this is main subject what stop a lot of people. Because first action, what I heard when I offer short-term rental business, people say, oh, but it is very risky. I don't want to have hotel in my house because it's going to have big problem, big damage. Actually, 100% opposite. Because long-term, depending again, for example, in Ontario now, actually, guys, I'm now it's... this is something that's not in my presentation, but just I want to touch basics. Since a lot of people from Ontario, who knows, who doesn't know, like from the April 1st, Ontario government changed dramatically the landlord-tenant's relationship. So first of all, the form, the rental agreement, what they force you to sign, you cannot change it, you cannot add any condition from you or delete the something that's written there. The worst things what exist there, so first of all, you cannot forbid smoke in the house. For example, you cannot put there no smoke. You cannot put there no pets. The funny thing is, starting this summer, I think July 1st, thanks to our new government, like marijuana going to be legalized in Ontario, but this is not the worst thing. The worst thing, they allowed grow up, I think, up to 4 pieces, the height up to 1 meter in the house, and they allowed legally smoke it. Excuse me, if I have my own house, So you try to say that starting July, I cannot do nothing if people won't have 10 big dogs, have 4 pieces of nice marijuana bushes, and smoke it whole day, 24 hours. Excuse me, but I don't want this type of business. The same, why I start telling you, just to check the property. For long-term rental, you actually very limit how many times you can come and check. People can tell, I don't want you to come, and you cannot do nothing. Can you imagine after these new rules become effective, you come to check the property in 6 months or 1 year? What you can see there, only God knows. In case of short-term rental, you have completely control. It means if you rent, for example, 1 week, 2 weeks, it means in 2 weeks, person who take care of it, your property manager or cleaning team, they come. Again, it's part of our system. I just tell you a little bit. They come, not just clean. They come with big list. We call it checkup list, check-in list. And they just put mark if they see any damage. For example, if it's kitchen cabinet open properly, if there are no problem running water in the washrooms or faucets, if there are no scratches, if they notice something, they put a mark. They put official complaint to the site that was booking made from, and actually we charge people for it because security deposit always involved. That's why you can check property every time after every checking out. Comparison with very limited time for long term. This is actually was main difference between these two types of rental. Now we talk about how actually what steps involved in each of them. For long term rental, don't take me wrong, we still continue doing it here. Actually in Florida, it's still much more safe and less headache do long term than in Ontario. Why? The law here more protect privacy, like private property. It's much easier with tenant here. It will take maximum 1 month comparison with 6 months if you're lucky in Toronto. Long-term rental. So very important part, screening the tenants. Main difference between Canada and US. In US, we have all kind of information completely open to public. So it means you can easily, without any special permission, you can easily find out people's credit score, if they have any criminal background, if they have any problem with previous landlords. You can always see actually if they how many properties they have. You can put any famous person last name, and public records, and you will see how much his property costs and where it's located. It's US. In Canada, we have everything hidden. That's why screening tenants very easy, but it's very important. In our case, we always involve licensed people. We have, for example, a special agency, like former agents from FBI, who have additional access to see everything from people. Even they can, if it's required, they can even see them, like, because they're private detectives. They can see their private conversation. Is there any suspicious things? It's better if you use this tenant. For $30, we can see everything for the tenant for the last 10 years, including credit check, recommendation, ability to pay, what is more important. Sometimes you can have tenants already in the house, so you find a house with tenants there, especially for multiple family. They have a lot of always in our inventory, duplex or triplex, what can cost you $200,000-$300,000, and it's already rented. People already there. In this case, it will take you only 1 month actually buy the property and just continue to take the rent. Finalize of contract, when you actually have, you bought the house, you just need to make contract with property management team who will be in charge for maintenance, collect payments, and do small repairs. Usually they do it in Florida 10-12% for long term. Also, their responsibility also will be find new tenants, see if it's checks, payments, and time, also deposit the checks to your account. and to be sure control the utilities pay in time. Example of long-term rental. This is a real example from MLS. So on the left side, we have Fort Lauderdale single detached, 2,000 square foot. This is average size of the house here. Rent per year house like this, it's 55,000, so it's slightly more than 4,000 per month. The only expenses what you have here, it's taxes, 4,700 per year. Again, as Glib mentioned before, also insurance can be involved, but if you don't have mortgage there, it's absolutely optional. In case if you decide to have it, it's around $100 per month. And on the right side of the screen, we have slightly smaller house in Hollywood, 1,800 square foot. What costs $355,000, it's $48,000 per year, that's exactly 4,000 rent. Taxes per year, $850,000. This is absolutely normal, regular houses in good areas, approximately 3-4 miles to the ocean. Two more examples for long term. But if before we have single house, single family house, here we have multi-family. Good example on the right side, on the left, sorry, duplex 1700 square foot in Hollywood. Asking price 269, rent per year 31,200, less than 3,000 property tax. And even smaller duplex and cheaper as well. 1500, 169 purchase price, 20,000 rent per year, taxes 2700. So actually, all this example give you idea. So the simple long term. Why I say the simple? Because in this case, you found the house, you hire property management, and that's it. It give you minimum 10% return. Otherwise, it doesn't make sense to take it. And of course, I don't. Talking about that house going to increase anyway in value. I cannot promise it will increase like in Toronto last couple of years. Everybody knew it will be not forever, but stable 2-3% it's increase every year. Shorter rentals. First of all, who is the main source of clients for shorter rentals? In case of Florida, of course, it's tourists. So now a little bit numbers. 2016, 110 million tourists, whole state. And income, what the tourists actually bring to the state, almost 110 billion. 2017, almost 10% more million tourists. Not all these tourists, it's come for vacation. Most of them come for vacation. Florida, always very interested state for people, for business. A lot of banks, Glit mentioned before, banks and corporations. A lot of different type of presentation. Just last week, Glit attend Craig Proctor, everybody knows, it's very famous guy, coach, real estate coach from Newmarket actually. But last 20 years, he do coaching North America. Every month or two, he come in Florida. And he's only one from his business. Mortgages, I have a bunch of mortgage financial advisors in Toronto. They come at least one time per year here in Florida for different presentations, seminar, shows, whatever, mainly. Plus, a lot of sport events. Since weather here even, almost even whole year, there are a bunch of sport events of different ages and groups what bring extra tourist people. We need, of course, all this million of tourists, they need places to live. Demography of tourists. Before we show you who actually what countries mostly buy in Florida, now we show you what countries mostly come as a tourist to Florida. To everybody's surprise, them almost one third part is UK. They like Florida, that's why, especially central part. A lot of a property management company, it's based actually from by people from UK. Next come other part of Europe, actually including Eastern Europe. Next goes North America. People from US coming, of course. Because this is the only state. I'm not talking about California, it's a different story, but Florida, it's only state, it's a subtropical climate. What's attract, of course, all American coming here. Canada. Asia come 10%, South America. And it's funny, people ask me always, what's the best season, or example, what months give you the most income for vacation rental? What about if there are off season? I need to tell you something. For example, now we have winter in US and in Canada. It's very hot season now for Florida because people from Canada, they hate snow, they don't want snow on the driveway, they come here. Summertime. You know that summertime, South America has their own winter. So we reverse now. For us, summer, it's like off season for Florida, but for South America, they actually like come to Florida because it's winter. So September, October, Gleb mentioned before, hurricane season, yes, but for a lot of people from actually US, it's very good time to come. Why? Because they can have vacation for half of the price. So it means every single month you can find people from different places. What keep your business running if you do right things, 90% at least you can have booking. What type of vacation rentals we have? By default, we can divide it in three different types. First one is guarantee income. There are some projects, mostly it's new condos. For example, we have nice Conrad project now in Fort Lauderdale. They have guarantee usually for first 3 4 years, guarantee rental program, so you have guarantee income from 6 to 8% from your purchase price. In other words, if you bought property for half of the million, they guarantee you will have up to 40,000 in your pocket. Doesn't matter. It's rented, not rented, off season, not off season. It also depends how many months you use for yourself. So you can use up to 3 months. So the more you use for yourself, the less guarantee income they can offer you. Next one, it's guarantee percentage from income. In this case, you become like partners with property management, what actual building offer. Usually it's 50-50. So it means they're responsible for advertisement, for all payments, for cleaning, but they want for it usually 50%. I don't want to say this is the best options, but for some people who doesn't want to be involved in any type of business, for example, they don't want to be involved itself to do something. So they just bought the unit, they know whatever it's earned, 50% they will get. And of course, last one is building a personal business. This is what I'm going to tell in the next sliding. Daily rentals. This is properties in Orlando. Some of the project in Orlando, it's the only one in whole Florida. For example, we have the reserved homes, gated community. So here on the top horizontal line, you see the type of season, low season. This is what we call beginning of fall. Medium, so it's usually end of spring, summer. Peak, it's winter and all holidays. On the left column, you can see this name. It's house models. The first one is the smallest one. I think it detached around 3,000 square foot, and the last one, Fremont, it's around 6,000 square foot. This is rate per day. This is how much you can get from the smallest house, from 340 to 550 per day, up to 600 for Fremont low season, 950 per day. If you'll ask me, who is going to pay $950 per day per house? Repeat again, this house 6,000 square foot, and you never guess how many bedrooms it has. 14. It means easily three, four family can comes and live there. If you calculate how much for this family will be cost buying regular rooms in hotel, it will be at least two times more. This price actually very often everybody has win-to-win situation. What's the main steps involved to actually set up vacation rental business? First, of course, you need to choose right location. Not all the location is good. It's also important what type of zoning that location has, because it can be very close to a good infrastructure, shopping plazas, beach, but by zoning, it can be not allowed as vacation rental. And it has to be compliant with HOA. It's like our maintenance or board of directors in a similar system in Ontario. So when first things, everything is set up, selected right way. The next one, we need to obtain necessary documents. Usually it's involved two type of permits or license. First one, it has to be business license because you run business. And second, it has to be tourist license. Both license can be easily get in a city of whatever city you use, Hollywood, Hollandale. It'll cost you up to 500 per year. Next one, if it's require cosmetic repairs, usually for vacation rental, we don't sell very bad condition property because we are not going fix and flip. Usually everything is already done. The only thing may be paint, maybe floor, maximum change something. And you need to put, of course, right furniture. Depending what, sometimes if you buy condo in condo hotel, furniture is already there. So it means you don't need to do this step. For the furniture, depending how big the house, it can cost you up to 10,000. Next one, you need set up certain contracts for maintenance your property. In our case, if you're talking about apartments, usually it's only cleaning. A lot of time they have already cleaning lady, cleaning team offered by condominium. So it's much easier for you. You don't need to people driving there. They're already working there full time. Depending on how big is your unit, it can cost you from $40 to $80 per one time. Just go ahead a little bit. Usually this part pay not by you but your guest. Actually, it's free for your cleaning. In case if it's house, cleaning can be from 100 to 250. Again, it's also you add this part to your rates when you create the listing. Two more important contracts for maintenance you should set up. It's a swimming pool and landscaping or lawn. Usually it's $80 for each of them per month. So since they come around one time per week, so $20 per one visit. Again, if it's condominium apartment, this step you don't need to be involved. And the next step, the more important, business advertisement and online booking. It's also involved setup in all main website, create listing, create house manual, put your rules, select, look on the competitors' rates, put this rate in your listing. Some people do it themselves because actually all the step do online, doesn't matter what place you're located. And we have good examples how people from different countries buy property here. We set up, help set up for them all the steps. The steps number five, they do themselves. If they do themselves, they save in this case from 15% to 20%. If you don't want to do it, no problem. We do it for on your behalf. You will get report every time somebody came. You will get report. You will actually see all money go directly to your account. And of course, on the everyday basis, it's required negotiations with customers. Again, you do it usually not by phone, but by online. You're just chatting with them, you answer the question. Usually it's part from step number five. Whoever do number five, the same person or team do number six. For example, if you hire us, to be your property management. We do an advertisement, an online booking, and negotiation with customer. A little bit about Airbnb. Who doesn't know, the site was created more than 20 years ago, almost 20 years ago. Yeah. Now it's offer the service 191 countries, and they offer more than 3 million properties. Very popular site, especially in Europe. It's not the only site that we use and we recommend to use, but it's, let's say, one from five. This is how it looks. Good example of Airbnb listing. Screenshot. So one of the like main picture on the top. This is small description. If you click on the arrow, it will show you more. It always show you right away for maximum how many guests it has capacity. In our case, it's 7 guests, 3 bedrooms, 3 bedrooms. It show rate per night. This nice tiny house, 3 bedroom, you can buy house like this from 400 to 600 right now, 1,000. Let's say I give example here. When we create this presentation, we just try pre-book on this summer. What is, if you remember, it's not peak, it's just like almost from mid to low season. For 2 weeks, house like this for 6 guests will cost you 368 per night times 14, 5,152. I remember I told a cleaning fee always add plus. So cleaning fee $250. Service fee. This is what Airbnb charge, but again, it charge not from you, from people who won't book your property. Occupancy tax. It's very interesting. In US, Airbnb charge taxes automatically. In Canada, for example, you're responsible to report the taxes, although they don't collect taxes. So total for this nice property 2 weeks will cost almost $7,000. And if you told me how often this house, I will tell you very simple. When you finish presentation, go Airbnb, choose Fort Lauderdale, single house. Last week we tried to see for the next 3 months everything booked completely. More than 1,000 properties, single house in Fort Lauderdale area, everything booked. Advantage of using online booking, Airbnb or similar. First of all, it's not attached to one place. For people who dreaming to have freedom, I'm not talking about only financial freedom. Freedom of moving any place. For example, today I live in Toronto. Tomorrow I want to live 3 months in Costa Rica. Next 3 months I want to live in Europe. But at the same time, I want to be sure I don't lose my business, I don't lose my clients. This is one of example of this type of business. Whatever place you're located, you can sit in under Palmas tree, control, negotiate with your clients, select, change rates, change description. Second advantage, full security of payment. We mentioned before, 100% all payments, it's paid in advance. Next one, security deposit in case of damage, what secure all your property. Next one, both Airbnb and Vrbo, they offer now automatically liability insurance directly from the site for $1 million. And another advantage, if you do everything right way, we guarantee you after 6 months, you will get super host recognition from website. What it will give you? It give you, first of all, very big promotion for advertisement. So actually Airbnb, because the more times your property booked, the more money they will have. So they're interested to promote you, but they cannot promote everybody. They need to be sure you do everything right way, you have positive reviews. Approximately 6 months it will take. They give you super host. They put on next level of promotion. They put on Google. They put you on different social media, and it's give you boost for your business, for the traffic, people who can see you. Actually, they also offer you, if you're super close, they offer you free photography. For example, but if you are in Florida, so we offer the service from us for free. If you any other place, you have super host, every big city, they have their photographer who come and make shots for your property. This is example for property management. Properties that located in the Great Miami area, for short-term rental, we can offer our service. But for example, if you buy property in Orlando, physically, we cannot manage your properties there, but they have every big city where is a lot of interesting project for short-term rental. We have companies that affiliate with us. For example, in Orlando, the company Loveris, it's actually based by a UK owner. Some of the example of service what they offer. So of course, they do management, they do lawn care, pool care, actually everything what I told you. Plus, they can do accounting on our behalf, and in this administration, to be sure that you don't have booking on the same day. For all repair, they offer 24-hour service, pest control, and of course, they help you for online booking. Plus to it, they do urgent service, monthly accounting reports, regular check, like checking list I told you. Plus they can offer a personal website. Quickly, okay, how long do you have it now? Almost 1 hour. I think you have 10, 15 more minutes. We're just going to talk about particular projects and type of property, what is good for short-term rental. As our presentation, we cannot explain about every single one. We just give general idea how it works, because for a lot of people, it's pretty new business. So what type of property is good for vacation rental? Because for long-term rental, every type of property good. If it's property, if it has four walls and roof, it's good for long term. For short term, not all of them. Condo, hotels, and apartment. This is looks like regular condo, but why we call it condo hotels? Because by zoning, it's allowed rent short term. We have, for example, pretty big problem now in Toronto. As I know, our last information, 4 and 5 condos in Toronto downtown still allowed by zoning for Airbnb. All other one up to 10,000 penalty if you try to rent in this type for short term. That's why US it's more strictly penalty if you do something wrong. That's why we want to be sure if you select the property in apartments, it from the beginning we know for sure it can be rented by zoning. Next type of property good for short term, resort houses and townhomes. The best example is Orlando. I show a little bit later how looks this community. Resort houses, it means it's actually gated community. Offer beside this, it's like subdivisions, but they have their own infrastructure, like condos. For example, they have one or two or three pools. They have water splashing, slidings, they have a bunch of restaurant, fitness, they have tennis courts, etc. Example of one of our clients who is actually super host, calendar. Actually, it's very easy to check how property is good, checking by statistic Airbnb. For example, you take the address, you want to check certain areas, how good it's for rental. You go to that area, you check, you choose any house, and you try to see the calendar. If the house is booked, so this particular days will be shadow or gray or just cross out. So it means when you see like this, it means the days is actually booked. Booked, it means the money already paid and the sitting in escrow account. Belong to Airbnb or Vrbo. When actually guests check in, decide the same day transfer money to you. So this particular site, I made screenshot, I think in January this year, last year, sorry. We start from March, I make it February. So if you can see in March only 5 days was available. Regular price rate for the house 320 per day, per night. April, everything was booked. May, everything was booked. Actually, it show very good what's the best season. Well, springtime, winter time. June, just 6 days. So all the screenshot was done in 1 day. So it means the house, if it's good area, if you don't put limit for booking, because you can put, for example, not book then more than 6 months in advance. This one, they didn't put any limit. So May, June, just 6 days. July, only 3 days available. August, a little bit more than 1 week. September, yeah, the season, only 1 week was empty. Don't forget, the screenshot was done beginning of 2017. October, half of month. February, they have different type of booking. It's not now this green one. They just cross it. Actually, February was booked everything. March, just 1 week was available. So the rule of thumb, right place, right market. Florida, 75% to 95% your ratio expect for booking. And Core Complex, this is one of the example of Orlando resort homes. On this top corner right picture, you can see houses. And in the middle, you see, actually, it's not house, sorry, it's clubhouse, like community center, houses, it's around. In the middle, you see the pool, the water splashes. This is very brief calculation. This particular community, it's actually brand new houses that's ready to buy. You don't need to wait like 6 months or 12 months. From 5 to 13 bedrooms houses. Location is 5 minutes to Disney. Price is from 369 to 757. Sizes from 25 to 6400. Since it's gated community, they have a lot of things to offer. They have maintenance fee or what we call HOA, around 500 per month. But for example, this particular community maintenance include even, you can see where it says maintenance. It's include internet, TV, remove garbage, irrigation for your landscape. Amenities, 9 restaurants, spa, rental income from 150 to 650 per day, depending on the season. If you calculate, if you're talking about cash payment, your ROI 10-15% with 75% occupancy. If we're talking about mortgage involved, your ROI will be 2.5, sorry, 1.5, 2 times more. Because you get percentage-wise much more because you invest less. Next one, Solterra, similar gated community in Orlando. Why talking about Orlando now? Because it's brand new houses. A lot of people like to buy brand new. Price is a little bit less. They located 20 minutes to Disney. Size is similar, but HOA is less. Up to 569,000, you can get house more than 6,000 square foot. Rental income slightly less, 250, 500 per day again. Property management for this property, as I told you, we have nice professional local property management. What take care about this business completely for you. We also have townhomes in Orlando area, also brand new. It's built by Canadian builder, by Minto. It's very famous in Ontario, this builder. Location just 5 miles to Disney. Price is around 300 square foot, pretty big size. 300,000, sorry. 2,000 square foot. Less than 400 maintenance. A lot of amenities. Rental up to 250 per day. If you make your mess, you get 5,000 roughly per month for the townhouse like this. This project, Conrad, I mentioned before, it's located in Fort Lauderdale on the beach. This particular project offers guaranteed rental income, one of the program. You can also rent by yourself, very close to airport and the cruise ship port. This is how it looks example of studio for this building. All the furniture is already comes with the purchase. They have pool located on the roof. Next project, it's also Fort Lauderdale, not far from airport. It's Condo Hotel. They offer studios, one or two bedrooms. Prices from studio, it's 185 up to 465,000. Maintenance also include everything, internet, electricity. The house, the condo has nice restaurant and it's exactly on the beach, very close to airport. For studio and season, you can get $200 per night. For studio, that costs 185,000. They also have cleaning team inside. I actually don't need take about care about pool or something. And this particular condo has very good response for rental because it's very huge demand for this particular area and neighborhood. Very quickly, we also have project in Costa Rica. This country actually it's become very interested for people from US and from Europe because it's very easy. You can get permanent residences there, especially if it's good for people who's going to be retired. Costa Rica offer very good medical system. Why a lot of Americans, I think more than 1 million now move Costa Rica. As you know, USA don't have, they're not so lucky like Canadian for medicine. Costa Rica offer almost free medicine. I think for family you pay $50 to get a prime residence here. They have three type of programs. Either you can invest up to 200, you can buy one house, two house, doesn't matter. You can invest in business just 60,000, or if you're a retired person, so it just shows that your pension at least once per month, and you can apply for a pensioner visa. To give you an idea about property costs there, studio 50,000 and up, two bedroom townhome 70,000 and up, three bedroom house, depending on the area, you can have 120,000 and up. Resume. What type of service besides regular real estate you can expect from our team? Of course, first of all, it's selection of real estate according to your needs. Most of our clients, we don't meet them our first appointment. It's not physical we meet, usually it's by internet or by phone, and we start continue negotiations. They start telling what they want actually, and they choose a property by internet. So they give us idea for what they needed, either it's for vacation or they want to invest or they're going to retire soon. Actually, who doesn't know, for the la from last November, I think, US and Canada has new regulations regarding how long Canadian citizen can be in US. It was maximum 6 months, like for everybody. Now, if you are Canadian senior citizen and you have property in Florida, let's say, not necessarily you bought it, you can rent it, but you must show a contract for long-term rent, at least 6 months. You can be here up to 8 months without actually losing your OFI privileges and without obligation paying US tax. Because if you know, if you live in US, doesn't matter, even if you don't have any status here, if you located in US once and 1 day, you obligate to report income tax. In case of citizen from senior citizen from Canada, 8 months, no obligation to do it. Okay, so next one, so we offer always we have inventory for passive income Freddy project. and it can be either resale. I already show a couple of example for resale, secondary market, or new construction. Because I cannot show everything in one presentation, different condos or different houses, different communities, what is good for vacation rental business. Why I call it passive income ready? Because the only thing you need there, set up it for this business, it takes 1 month, and maximum 2 weeks, and start giving you the profit. Another service what we offer, we help them to get a mortgage in US. Financing is possible up to 100%. Financing up to 100%, it means if you have your equity in Canada. So it's based on it, we can help you to take line of credit, refinance. Any kind of house, you can get easily 100,000-200,000. Having this money, you can buy actually our property, what we offer 55 plus, you can get starting from 70,000-80,000. And you also can get profit from by renting it. For certain project, for example, all Orlando projects, we have bonus from builders. If people buy it for family up to 4 people, we offer free travel to Florida and staying in hotel up to 3 days. We also offer full package to set up rental business, like all the steps what we told you to be involved, from set up the listing, find buy the necessary furniture, making a picture, video, create listing, follow up with your clients. All the setup we offer you, doesn't matter is it long or short term. Not just you buy property and you don't know what to do after that. Property management, we offer our own property management in Great Miami area or our affiliated partners in other parts of Florida. Part of our brokerage service is also immigration investment programs, especially for green card. If you have in mind, for example, invest money through buying investments and get green card, it's required a certain amount of money. Right now, it's, I think, 500,000. We also have a special type of project. You cannot just, people ask me, if I just buy a house, can I get green card? Unfortunately, no. It has to be done through regional centers who has project approved by immigration of USA. We also have program, people who become interested, or just get regular business visa. You can also ask us question about how it works, and we give you certain information. And service of our in-house team. As Gleb mentioned, we have accountant, actually our accountant who specializes in USA businesses and taxes for Canadians. He's located in Toronto. People who live there can call him or meet with him. If you have any question about how better to set up your tax structure, either you need to open company, corporation, or you need to buy for your own name, he can give you idea depending on your situation. Title company, lawyer, mortgage broker, appraisal, and of course, home inspectors. Yes. Gleb, want to say something?
All right, so we are nearing our end.
Yeah, you can also give you our contact information. This is a phone number, Canadian number, USA number. You can also contact us by email, usamarketgroup@gmail.com. You can find our Facebook pages, Florida Passive Income Property and Florida for Canadians Facebook. We also have our top group, Florida Real Estate Investment Club. As we mentioned before, we do, you can find now the website. Mm-hmm. We also do seminars, webinars. So our next webinars will be March 6th. Actually, it will be next Tuesday. Let me see.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Tuesday is the same time, 7:30. We'll be talking about Airbnb, how to actually set up it, what secrets to do it right way and how to get super host less than 6 months. You can do it actually not necessarily in Florida. We also do this type of service in Toronto, and you'll be surprised, but Toronto also can show you very good response in this type of business. If somebody has any questions, can you please type it now?
Open the chat room. If you guys have any questions, just type it in the chat box and we'll answer them.
How much US tax Canadian resident must pay? Okay, first of all, Alexei asked because average price, or I just response by who asked first. How many sales last year? I still don't understand this question. I just can tell it's increased around 7%. I can tell you from last year we start see a lot of multiple offers, what was actually very rare before for Florida market. How much US tax Canadian resident must pay when sells his house? Sergey, everything depends what he is going to do with the house. So it means if you'd like to just keep all the profit, it's one thing. If you'd like to reinvest it to buy another house, it's another thing. If the house was bought on your personal name, again, it's another thing. And if house was bought like corporation name, it's another thing. If house costs less than 300,000, so it means it's a lot of if house costs less than 300,000, it's also a different story. The best thing, you can type, if you give your email to type request USA Market Group, I can send you our accountant contact information. It also depends what tax brackets you have. For example, if you use it for the business, you have a lot of expenses, and you keep all the profit there, you don't need to pay. If house bought for American corporation, it's actually not belong, you don't need to pay anything as Canadian, because you just need to pay as a corporation. And if you don't want to remove money from US, I have some clients who use this profit spending in US, not moving to Canada. So it's again different story. Как далеко от пляжа обычный дом? Примерно 250-300. How far is from Victoria. Beach? Yes, regular house. 250-300. Victoria, it depends what area you're talking about. If you're talking about Hollywood area, the house for this price, actually you can buy only duplex. It's located like, I don't know, 5, 7, 8 miles from ocean. If you're talking about Fort Lauderdale, 300, yeah, you can still find 300 house. It's maybe 4 or 5 miles. But if you're talking about, for example, St. Lucia County, it's like 3 hours north from Hollywood, from Miami, very quiet place. You can find for 250 almost on first line, like 300 meters. So it depends. But you need to understand, if you're talking about for your particular usage, like you want to buy a house and use yourself, it's one story. If you're thinking about vacation rental, the best response, the best return, show houses what located 2-3 miles. Why? Because their price not too expensive, but they rent it a lot. Most of the people, but they must have pool, of course. Most of the visitors, they don't go to ocean at all. So they find with the pool, for them more important that, for example, beer store or restaurants or Walmart located close by walking distance. Where to park car when we come on the beach? You know, there are some places, for example, if you're talking about Fort Lauderdale, there are some places that you can find even free parking. For example, Dania Beach. From Fort Lauderdale Airport, it's just 10-15 minutes. Plus, you know, it's very funny, you know, what I can offer you. Use Uber. You know how many people now use Uber? When I go from my house here to airport, it's like 15 minutes, 20 minutes drive. It's 10-15 bucks. If you go your house located 5-10 minutes by car, you can pay $5-7 Uber. And you don't need to rent the car even to buy for parking or something. Why go on ocean, Victoria? Very simple. I don't know, if you pay attention, for example, if you go all inclusive, Mexico, Cuba, Dominican, 90% of people who came on this type of resort, they sit on the pool. You know, guess who is going on the beach? Russian. That's it. Because in their culture, people don't like to swim. They're afraid of water. Plus, don't forget, a lot of times people who, remember I told you, people who rent the houses, they don't go on vacation. Sometimes they go by work, business trip. They don't have time even go there. But for them, it's cheaper or they feel more comfortable working from the house. I know 100% because some of clients who has vacation rental, they have security cameras. They don't have it them inside of the house. It's of course against privacy, but they have outside and they can see exactly what people doing, like how many hours they spend. Most of the time they sitting in the pool. That's it. Yes, you can buy a house very close to the beach, but on Fort Lauderdale it can cost you a couple million. Even if you rent it, I don't know, 1,000 per day, the return still will be not the same. Plus you need to invest a lot. So the golden middle, let's say, the house that located not very close, or you can buy on the first line, you can buy condo. But see, condo apartment, let me show you, for example, this one. Condo resort, yeah? You can buy two bedroom apartment here. It'll cost you 400,000. But for the same price, you can buy a house that you have full control, much more people can be occupied, and you have better return. But if for you more priority ocean, no problem. The same price, buy two bedroom on the ocean. And it's not how many miles in this case. You just you go elevator, you just go down to the beach, and that's it. You on the beach. Okay, guys, thank you for coming to us. Thank you for visiting us tonight.
Hope you learned something new today.
Yes,
we're
going to
be continuing weekly. We do these webinars, so make sure you check the next one, which is going to be, again, as Serge said, March 6th. At 7:30 p.m. So if you registered for this webinar, you're also going to get an email with the link to register for the next one.
Yeah, and for Victoria, I wish Victoria and everybody at least play to lottery. So you say you need to save some money.
Yeah, because Donald Trump is actually, there's rumors that he's going to be, you know, canceling the green card lottery sometime like next year and the next few years. So, you know, better make it in time.
Not, I mean, not only this lottery, I mean, regular lottery, to have money.
Green card to win the green card is also like taking a lot of money because if you don't you do it the regular way, it does cost quite a lot.
Okay, guys, contact, be in touch, and we're always ready and glad to answer your question. We are going to be in Toronto in a couple of weeks. Actually, wants to, and I plan to make some presentations there, depending how many people are willing to meet. So keep in touch and see you soon next week. Thank you.
Take care.
Bye bye.